Yes, so we sponsored the issue of the host of parties. Maybe the genesis is when we come when we came to Bulawayo, we started the PILOS Center of Excellence. We're doing outreaches, and that's when we realized there's a concept called host of parties. So we're trying to address it, to see sometimes doing some campaigns, some matches, and all those things. But we later thought to say, why not find out what is really causing the host of parties? How best can we address the Vuzu parties? And the only way to do that is do a research. So that's why we partnered Grassroots Soccer to do the research on Vuzu parties. We wanted just to know where is it happening, which age groups are attending, what activities are happening in those Vuzu parties, and how best can we address the issue of Vuzu parties. So from the results of the research, yes, number one, the Vuzu parties are happening. And they're actually very common in Bulawayo, not just in Bulawayo, but it appears the rest of the country is actually picking up. It's only the nomenclature, the names given to the Vuzu parties, which differs. So even here in Bulawayo, the Vuzu parties have different names which are given to them. But the white parties, which are very common, the six parties also, so there are different names which are given. So it's quite common, not just in Bulawayo, but the rest of the country. So who attends is mostly the young. And usually they say these young have absentee parents. Maybe they've got access, they've got a house, their parents are living outside. That's one, those ones who support. The second one is adults who want to take advantage of the young girls. So they will host a Vuzu party at their place, then probably drag the girls and take advantage of them. So those are the results to say this is what will be happening. So what will be happening at the Vuzu party is mostly drinking alcohol, abuse of drugs, and also issue of sexy marathons, which happens there. And there's a lot of, some they say they can sleep by 5 to 10 people that night. So there's a lot of sex going on. It seems from the research it's unprotected, which makes it very risky for the young ones. So some of the respondents also say they attend these food parties 5 to 50 times, which is quite worrisome. It means almost on a weekly basis, or twice or thrice a week, someone's going for Vuzu parties. So it's quite a worry phenomenon. So in terms of how best to address it, from the research, it seems we have to look at different components. Number one, we need to look at the component of the youth, how best to address them, get programs that addresses the youth. One key issue which was found out is the youth are saying we don't have enough facilities, like sports facilities, so that they can entertain them, so that they, at least the energy they have, they can dissipate it somewhere else. So the youth, we need to come up with a system where we have a place, a safe place, where they can entertain themselves, be it sports facilities, be it a place where they can play their games or something like that. So we need to revive that. The community centers in the cities, I think those are key issues which the local authorities also need to look at. So that's the address in terms of addressing the youth. Then also the community level, the Umbundu is actually coming up to say we need to have that community approach where every child is your neighbor's child is your child. If something's happening on your neighbor's place, we need to inform maybe the parents or something like that. So that's at the community level. Then the community leaders as well. It's not just the community leaders, the political leaders as well. They need to get involved in terms of how best to address this. So in terms of going forward, we are proposing to have a stakeholders meeting where we are proposing probably to have a committee which will be looking at the Vuzu parties, how best to address it, which areas are we going to be addressing first. So it's a phenomenon which is quite common in Bulawayo, and it's a phenomenon which we need really to address so that at least we can reduce the transmission of HIV. You can imagine if one person has HIV in a group of 20, one or two people, then they sleep around with all the girls who are there. We are going to have HIV transmission because most likely it's unprotected sex because they were under the influence of either drugs or alcohol. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.